Welcome children. In this video, we will learn how to use a protector. Protector, a tool used to measure angles. We also call it D. Let me show you a close-up of this. Here, it has angles written on it. As you can see here, starting from 0, increasing 80 and 90 right in the center, that is the right angle, as we have learnt in the types of angles. Moving on to 180 degree. Then there is an outer part which is starting from here, 0 is here, increasing in the center 90 right angle, and then moving on to 180 degrees. Now, why there are two? That I will explain you the usage of both. Here, you can see I have already drawn an angle AOB. Remember, when we draw an angle, we always name it as AOB. O in the center, that is the point where the angle is being formed. We can also name it as BOA, or we can name it as angle O, because this is the exact point where the angle is being formed. So in the three letters, this letter should always be in the middle. Now let's learn how to measure the angle. To begin with, when we start measuring the angles, I'll keep a white paper under it so that it is clearly visible to you. This point, the center part in your protector, this should come exactly at the point where the two lines are meeting. And then we look for zero. So the first step in the angles is that this point, this row, we mark this as 0 degrees. The baseline is always at 0 degrees. So we match our protector with the 0 degrees. We will go further. Now I am placing this center point, the center line, as I have shown you, exactly here where the two lines are meeting. That is at point O. And it should be exactly in the straight line. The bottom line, the red line, should not be visible now. It should exactly align with this zero. Now, as this is the baseline, 0 degree, as I told you, baseline is always at 0 degree. We will look for zero on our protector. Keep your finger on the zero and then start moving towards the other line here where it is ending. This line is ending at 70 degrees, right? You can see this is ending at 70 degrees. So the measure of this angle is 70 degrees. Angle AOB is 70 degrees. We write it here also. Angle AOB is equal to 70 degrees. Or we can write angle BOA is equal to 70 degrees. Or we can write angle O is equal to 70 degrees. All the three names given to the angle are correct, because the angle is formed exactly at O point O. Moving on to the next example. Now here, angle PQR. Okay, now the angle is being formed at Q. So Q letter will come in the middle. PQR. Or we can name it as RQP. Or we can name it as angle Q. Now to measure this, the first point, we mark the baseline as 0 degrees. This is always at 0 degrees, as I told you. Just look once again here. we will put this middle line, this exactly at the point where the two lines are meeting or where the angle is being formed. And then we will align it with this baseline on the protector, this baseline, right? Let's put it here. Okay, it should be exactly, and now the bottom line should not be visible. The bottom line should not be visible. It should be, I'm just zooming it for you so that it is absolutely clear to you all. Right? Now, you can see this bottom line is not visible. Moving on to zero. We will look for zero. Now, zero here is in the outer circle. Right? So, we will start from here and we will move on further. Right? We are going on further. Starting from zero, we will move our finger where this other line is there. Now, this line is exactly in the middle of 120 and 130 degrees. It is exactly at 125 degrees. So, this angle is 125 degrees. Right? We write it like this. Angle PQR is equal to 125 degrees, or we can write angle RQP is equal to 125 degrees, or we can write angle Q is equal to 125 degrees. Remember, when we are naming with three letters, the point where the angle is being formed, that should always come in the middle. That should always come in the middle. I hope I'm clear to you. If you want to have a closer look of the previous one also, I'm just repeating it again. Here, you can have a clear view of this. As I told you, that we are going to keep our protector here in the point where it is joining, and we will align it. Now, here the inner circle is having zero. This is the 0 degree, and we are aligning it with inner circle. Moving our finger from zero towards the next line, which is exactly at 70 degrees. So, the measure of this angle is 70 degrees. I hope this is clear to you how to measure the angles.